Hello students and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. So today we are going to discuss with you how to start your preparation for SBI clerk exam for the English section, right? So I am with NCI Yadav, the head of English department of bank exams today. So let's start. So tell me, NCI, how a student should start his preparation for English section of SBI clerk exam? I mean, how he should start actually? Tell me.
Okay. If you are particularly asking me about the English section, they have to make a study plan for 10 days, 15 or 20 days, okay, in which they have to allot a specific time for each section, right? Okay. For the unseen passages or for the error spotting for the vocab, and they must read at least editorials of every newspaper. If they consider, they can read the Hindu, okay, that has the easiest editorials, I think. So they must read one editorial that is related to current affairs, or they don't go for the political ones. They should, okay, go for the related to banking editorials.
So point number one is the newspaper's editorial. Mm-hmm. Then
they should make a study plan for 30 days.
Okay, the student, you should make a study plan, a 30-day study plan. What you are going to study for next week or next, you know, you should make a plan in an Excel sheet, right? Take a printout, right?
I think can make a study plan for you and you can work on that also.
Okay, so we are going to make a study plan for you. I didn't know about that, she told me. Okay, we are going to make a study plan for you, right? And then you should read the newspaper every day. She is recommending the Hindu. I personally recommend the Indian Express. Both are good newspapers, right? You should read the editorial portion, right? So these are the two important things that we just discussed now. So why students are afraid of English section? Why students are afraid of those, you know, lengthy paragraphs? Why students are afraid of it?
Students are afraid because they are not prepared to attempt their those questions. Whenever we are in schools or in colleges, we just cram the questions and we write it in the exams. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to the exams of SBI, PU, clerk, etc., basically tests our ability to comprehend the reading comprehensions, how strong our grammar is. Okay. So when a student is not prepared related to grammar, if they don't have a strong grammatical base, they are not going to crack the exam. So that is why they are afraid, because they don't have a strong command over the language and a command over the English grammar.
Okay. So one more thing, we need to discuss about the vocabulary, right? I mean, students are facing a lot of difficulty in, you know, learning new words. I mean, even in the vocab section, there are synonyms, antonyms. Even to understand a reading comprehension, they find it difficult to read a reading comprehension just because new words. I mean, is there any particular kind of a technique to learn new words? How they should, you know, tackle this?
Okay, so the best way to learn vocabulary is to use it. Whenever you see a new word in a paragraph or somewhere in the newspaper or on the news, on TV, first thing you have to do is to find the meaning. Without knowing the meaning of a word, if you use that, you are going to make a mistake. The first thing, find the meaning, and then you can use the word in various sentences. The more you use the words in your sentences, the more you are going to learn it. You will memorize it in a better way. And the second thing is that whenever you find a word, the word takes various formations, like a verb, adjective, adverbs. So you have to use the formations of words in different sentences, and you can learn that in a better way.
Okay, so let me summarize it for you. I mean, you should use new words, right? Instead of just cramming a vocab list that we are actually providing, just don't cram it. Just don't, you know, just read it. Actually use the words, right? Whenever you are reading the editorials from the Hindu or the Indian Express, just don't just go through the news or editorials. Whenever you find any difficulty in any word, just try to search it on your mobile. You have the smartphones, right? So do you recommend any mobile application for vocab?
They can download the dictionary first.
Okay, dictionary, okay.
Having the dictionary in the mobile is going to help you.
Okay, Merriam Dictionary is Oxford Dictionary. The apps are free, apps are available. That's what I recommend. There are many other applications are available, unofficial ones, but I don't personally recommend them. So please stick to the basics, stick to Oxford or Merriam or Cambridge, right? Those are the best sources of, you know, vocabulary preparation to improve your vocab actually. So tell me, what if a student is weak in the English grammar, what he should do, he or she should do?
Okay, so if you are weak in grammar, if you don't have a base of grammar, first thing you have to do is to learn the rules. Without learning the rules, you cannot attempt the error spotting questions. And you do have the close test in the English section of SBI Clerk. So to attempt that and to have a strong command over English grammar, you have to learn the rules. For that, I recommend the 60-day basic course that we have.
So students, let me interrupt. So students, we have a 60-day English course in which we are uploading video classes every day. We are teaching. This is like a classroom course in which we are uploading the video lectures, we are providing the notes, and we are providing the test. So if you want to join the course, just go to bankexamstoday.com. There is 60 days English course. The demo course is already available. The demo notes are available. A lot of good study material is available on bankexamstoday.com. So just go to bankexamstoday.com, right, and take the course if you want to. In case you have any doubt, you can directly call me, right? My number is 906720100. The number is available in the description, right? Since, yeah, just one more thing. So how a student can actually improve his accuracy in the English section? What I see is a lot of students, what they do is, if there are 30 questions in the English section, they attempt 30 questions, but like 10, 12 are correct, 10, 12 are, the remaining are wrong, and they end up, you know, scoring just 7-8 marks, right? So that is a big issue with the students, the problem with the accuracy. How they can actually improve their accuracy? That's a very important question.
Yeah, that is very important, because whenever it comes to accuracy, the student must have a focus. Whenever he is doing the reading comprehension, he has to just do the reading comprehension only. Just don't go to the error spotting or jump to the para jumbles, right? So first thing you have to do is to read the reading comprehension thoroughly, find the meanings, and understand the passage. If you don't understand the passage,
but here is a problem. So there is a problem, like there is a problem of, you know, availability of time. You just have, I think, 30 minutes for the whole English section. Yeah. No,
in the prelims exam.
Okay, the pattern has been changed. I am not aware about it. Sorry. So how to manage their time actually?
They should practice daily. They should give their time to reading comprehension. Mm-hmm. 10 minutes for reading comprehension, 10 minutes for error spotting, and 10 minutes for other topics, right? Then they have to check their answers. First, I would recommend that the students must just clear their doubts. If they don't clear their doubts, they are going to hang in doubts. If you find a question difficult, if you think that you have some doubt, you must clarify in your offline coaching centers or
one more thing. The students, most of the students who are watching this video, who are, you know, accessing our courses, most of them, they don't go to a coaching center, right? They are dependent upon our courses, you know, our study material. So tell them about our courses. So how we can actually help them, how, you know, they can get benefit from that online study material, the video lectures available on YouTube, on our courses, via, you know, PDF notes are available. What are the various sources available on the internet? They can open their phone and they can read it. They can take the test. So tell us about how they can use all the study material.
Basically, I would recommend the 60-day course, because in this course, we are doing everything from the very basics to the advanced level. Okay. I will first teach you the grammar rules, then I will take the test. Okay? And along with that, I'm giving the reading comprehension on daily basis. And if students are stuck somewhere, if they don't understand a question, a paragraph, or a meaning of something, they don't understand anything, they just come to me, they just drop a text on the group we have. And I just
simply, are you replying every day?
Yes, I do reply every text and do reply every query they have, because I think if you don't get your queries clear, you are going to have some doubts in your mind whenever you are in exam. So it is better to get them cleared and have a clear understanding of every topic.
One more question, Insya. For example, the test series, you know, text. Do you recommend any third-party test series provider, or are you going to provide that test within your course that you are doing right now?
Yeah, I do have my own test. I do have my own criteria to judge the students and to assess their abilities. Okay. Because every student is different and their learning capabilities are different. So if I recommend the different third-party test series, I am not sure about how well they are going to do that.
Exactly. There are a lot of good test series providers available in the market, but personally I don't recommend you students to take all those tests right now. I mean, you should take at max 7 to 8 tests or at max 10 tests, right, just before the exam. In the last week of, you know, before taking the exam, you should take the test series. But right now, this is not the right time to take the test series, right? You should focus on, you know, basics. You should focus on how to, you know, on particular chapters, actually. For example, how to attend the reading
comprehension. Sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. In the course, we have what we do is we just first do the chapter, and then we have a worksheet of error spotting, which helps them to understand the error spotting concepts easily.
Okay, so many of these worksheets, that's what she is telling me. Many of these worksheets are available for free, and you can just download them from bankexamstudent.com. Okay, the links to that grammar book, the 60 days course, the grammar book, and even the worksheets, a few worksheets that are available for free, I will provide those links in the description. Don't worry about it, right? So, the last question is, I mean, just before somebody is going for that, for example, for that exam, suppose I'm going for the exam, how much time is required for the preparation of this English section? I mean, how much time is required?
I think they should devote at least 30 days for their English section only.
30 days for English section only?
If they are preparing, they have to devote at least 4 to 5 hours for the English section.
Every day.
If they are weak in English.
If they are weak in English.
If you have strong grammar base, you just devote 2 to 3 hours. But if you have weak grammar, then you can contribute 5 to 6 hours.
Okay. Do you think that students should make their notes themselves?
No.
So you are going to provide
the notes? I am going to provide the notes.
Okay, you are going to provide the notes. Yeah. So any other addition that you want to make in that discussion?
I just want students to clear their minds and have a ability to learn English language as it is a language. It is not very difficult to learn, and if you have make your mind that you want to learn a language, you can learn. Don't think that it is a difficult thing, you can't do it, or you can't attempt it in your exams. You can do it, but with the help of our course, you are going to do it in a better way.
Okay, our course, actually. Okay. So that's all for today, students, from NCR. So if you have any doubts, students, you can actually call me anytime. My number is available on Bank Exams Today and even in the description, right? So if you have any doubt regarding the SBI clerk exam, you can directly call me, you can directly email me, even WhatsApp me, right? Actually, I am going to answer all of your doubts. The previous papers and model papers are also available on bankexamstoday.com. I am also going to provide the links to the previous papers. The link is available in the description. Students, before, you know, signing out, please make sure that you have subscribed to our channel, and please like this video. If you're unable to understand anything, please comment below. We are going to answer all of the comments. So don't worry about it. So my number again, 906720100. So that's all for today, students. Bye. Say bye. Bye.